Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. Welcome to another one of our lessons. In this guitar strumming lesson, we are basically going to use 16th note patterns pretty much throughout. 16th note basically means you divide the beat into four equal units or swinging units. You could swing these divisions as well. Very different than an 8th note division, which is 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and, where you're dividing the beat into two units. 3 and 4 and. With 16s, you're going 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 4 divisions for every pulse, right? So what's going to happen is, you're not going to necessarily play these rhythms faster. You're just going to have more interesting points to place your respective hit points at. So a lot of these rhythms are going to probably just start with muted sounds, which you do with your left hand, and you continue strumming in the right hand. So you get this muted sound, and then you start inducing certain chord hits. For example, a G major chord wherever need be. There we go. Right, so most of the patterns will have that endless strumming pattern. So if you don't hear an actual chord, you're going to hear some kind of a noise. And I think more than it sounding very, very groovy, which I think those ghost notes are very, very important for, it also helps a musician like me, or I'm sure you, also keep in time when your hand kind of goes like this endlessly. Again, for the lesson, we are just going to take very open chords like C major, E major, maybe E seventh, A minor, F, G, E minor. Very simple open chords are going to be used for this lesson. So get out your guitars and let's get started right away. And before we do, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, hit the bell icon for regular notifications. Leave us a comment, like the video, share the video if possible, and now let's get cracking. So we have 5 16th note based or accented guitar patterns with a lot of percussion. All are very groovy, very popular, very funky, if you want to use that word. And I thought, what better rhythm to start off with than a Latin rhythm or a salsa rhythm, which is popularly known as the song clave, which basically feels like this. You hear this a lot, right? Ta, 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 ta. So these hit points are what we want to generate on the guitar. So you go. With the pulse. But that's not how we are going to play it. Okay, you could start. Maybe you could start with the accents, let's say over a C major chord. And where are the points at? 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a and 4. 1E and a 2E and 4. And if you observe, your foot or your leg or your pulse needs to always be there while you play a 16th note groove. Otherwise, it can run away from you very quickly and your band or your drummer are not going to be very happy. So, slow it a bit. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and 4. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E. Little faster. Now, when you take this with a chord context, let's say a C major chord. These are the hits with a little bit of muting or stopping. That's the clave. 1E and a 2E and a 3. So how I generally like to play the clave is, instead of doing these, you know, unless you're doing like George Michael's Faith, like that's pretty much the pattern of that song, which is very choppy, very 80s glamish. What you could do is you could just maintain a nice consistent vibe of just going downstroke, upstroke, slightly quicker since it's 16th notes, and then play the pattern using actual chord sounds or sounding chords as opposed to the ghost. So your left hand is going to work on the actual chord and the nothing, the ghost or the mute, as we call it. So it goes something like 1E and a 2E, and start with this, all ghosts. 1E and a 2E and a... Now, bring in the chords at the clave hits, which are... That's the pattern. So your hand is essentially going with the... Start slow. Let's take a G chord, something different. So at no point am I not doing this movement, right? If you have a plectrum, you can do it pretty much the same way. I just prefer to use my fingers. That's how I've been learning or playing for all these years. Probably because I'm also a piano player, so fingers work a lot better than the thing which you hold. So, something like this. So you go... Try to get a nice clean sound with your ghostings and your mutings. You don't want to buzz things, you don't want to ring things and things like that. I'm sure you already know that if you've played the guitar, you know that those buzzes and some random harmonics which may come. So you need to work on the quality of the sound. That is also very important. That's what even someone like me continues to try and do to this day. Right, guys? So that was a song clave. You can also play the song clave in a couple of interesting ways. First of all, you can do it either straight or swing. So this is the straight version. And this is the swing version. Swing, you may want to play it slightly slower to feel the swing. You could start with just the hits, then swing it, and also thus bringing in the ghost notes. Or keep it straight. Straight doesn't mean faster. Neither does swing. It's the same tempo. You're just altering that the inside beats or the sub-beats or the subdivisions by moving them slightly later. Okay, the other thing you could do is have maybe two chords over one bar. Like you could take it as 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Or you could have three chords in a bar. So do consider those possibilities. Like you could do G, 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 F, F, G, 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 B flat, G, 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 F, F, C, 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 D, D, E. Get all that vibe going on for you. So do consider getting used to the clave, then getting options of swinging it and straightening it, and then obviously changing your chords, playing around. But start off with just maybe just a nice muted, ghosted kind of a feel. Let's move on to the next exciting rhythm pattern. Right, so the next rhythm pattern is very inspired by reggae. I guess you could actually call it a reggae guitar rhythm pattern. So what happens in reggae with respect to what the guitar does? The guitar generally plays the chord hits at the ends of the bar of a four. So if you take 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... So what you want to do is maybe take a C major chord like this. 1 and 3 and 4. First practice just doing up strokes, and the down strokes will really not really be there. You kind of go down, but you're going down to mute the guitar. So the sound is only coming with respect to our upstrokes. Okay, so this is one aspect of the reggae feel. So try this out. Everything's gonna be alright now. Everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna. Also, what I'm trying to do when I'm muting it, I'm trying to focus on the noise I'm making with that percussion. The guitar is a very percussive instrument, so you don't want to just bring your hand down randomly. You want to also hear the quality of the sound and figure out if you like that, you know, and slowly but surely work on that sound as you keep practicing, right? You could also, if you have the opportunity, you can connect the guitar to an amplifier or a speaker or a microphone and try to listen to what it sounds like, you know. This sound, you know, so you could go different ways. You could try and kind of knock on the guitar a bit. Or you can just get the nice, the string slapping kind of sound. So that's the basic idea of reggae, but it's not complete unless you add an element of swing, which is what the genre likes. So what was once this can now become what's happening there? 1 E and, 2 E and, 3 E and, 4 E and. So maybe every alternate beat you could add a double and go ta ta da ta da ta da ta in a 16th swing. 1 E and, 2 E, 2 E, 2 E. So at the 2 E I'm creating both strokes. So or at the 4. But both the 2 and the 4. You're not able to get the that extra 16 note ghost, it's fine. You can just go just upstrokes, but work on your muting. Then that ghost, ta-da. Go through the notation, go through the hit points and try to count 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. It'll really help. And eventually, of course, you make it very natural to the body as you play. Try to always relax, stay in a relaxed environment while you do this stuff. Let's move on to the next rhythm. Right, the next 16 note pattern includes an interesting accent, some percussion, lot of ghost notes, lot of offbeat variations as well. So let me play it for you and try to slow it down and guide you as to what all is going on. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and will be the ideal way to go about the counting process. That's how it's been and that's how it's going to be in this lesson. So it's 1E and. So you do two downs. Down, down. So let's get that first. 1E and a 2 and a 1 and 2 and a 1E and. Get this first. So that's where it goes a bit off. So the first two beats are ta da dum dum. You can also vocalize it. Tan 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 taga dun tan tan taga dum dum tau taka juku dum pow chika dum boom. You can just do something with your voice to motivate your guitar to get it done. So this is the first two beats only. So tan 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 ta da ta da ta. So moving forward with all the four beats, 1E and a 2E and a mute E and 4. 1E and a 2E and a mute E and a 4 E and a 1 E and a I like that random, not so random, very exciting percussion noise which I've introduced at the 3. So one tan tan ta da ta dan tan. So it kind of chokes the sound at the 3, and also gives you that percussion which you need in the guitar, right? So tan dan tan ta ga ta dan tao tam pam pam para param pam chika chika. Now you could do a couple of ghosts or continue strumming the same chord at the and the of the 4. So tam pam pam para taram pow pam pam pow para param 4 ander. But if you are getting bored at the 4 ander, then the and the can be played either with ghosts or with the same chord right there. And a nice preparatory thing to do before you actually work on this could actually be to take some time off and maybe do this sort of an exercise. You do two downs at the eighths and then do 4/16th notes down up, but muted, just to get your actual sounding chords and your ghosted chords. So you go down, 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 mute, down, down, mute, 4 mutes. That itself is quite a nice rhythm if you ask me. Then come back to what we have on hand now. And a 2. Also, what I like to do is accent the 2, play the 2 a little stronger. So and even the 4 could be accented. Let's do it with a nice pulse. Okay, let's just take it a bit slower. Accents at the 2 and the 4, and also the ghosting or the muted or the percussive sound at the 3. And a 2e and a 3e and a 4e and a 1e and a 2. So that's the next pattern for you, which uses ghost notes, some accents, as well as that nice percussion sound which the guitar always brings. Let's move on to pattern number 4. Pattern number 4. Again, 16th note based, 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4e and a. The way I've constructed it is I'm doing 1e and a, and then I'm keeping some silence there. So you could do the silence as, you could stop the guitar, or what I like to do is just toggle between the actual chord and the ghost. So 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4e and a. So you see what's happening there? Some a lot of off beats. After the 1e and happens, it just goes completely off the grid, so to speak. That it is actually in the grid, but in the 16th note dividing by 4 grid. So 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a, 4e and a. Okay, so after you do 1e and, then it's just going to be e's and r's throughout the piece. No on beats, no and beats. So let me demonstrate that again. 1e and a 2 will be ghosted. 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4e and a. And in some cases, at the ghost notes, instead of actually doing that, you could also kind of make the percussive noise demonstrated throughout this lesson. So things like that could come into the play. If not, just go through the pattern which is notated for you. Down, up, down. Down, up, down, ghost, ghost. Up, 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 up. Okay, after down, up, down, it just goes up. Down, up, down. Up, 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 up. Change. Could try and get that snare drum like sound versus the ghosted sound. You could do either one which suits you better. Again, let's do this slightly slower. One E and E and E and E and E and E and one E and two E and E three E four E and love this rhythm. Can go on and on with this rhythm, actually. Let's move on now to the last pattern for this lesson. You're going to really like it. Do stay tuned and let's move on. Last pattern for the video, guys. This one basically is what I call as the 3-3-2 feel generated over 16th notes. So if you hear what I just played, you can actually go. These are where the accents are. It's almost like a tresillo, which we call it. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and pa. So all those were ghosts, just to show you the accents. So 1E and a 2. So first get the accents. I think that is very important. So 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E na 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 and a 40 and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 40 and a 1E and a 2E and a dun dun dun. Now the whole pattern is based on first two beats are down, down, up, down, down, and a 2E and a 3E. Okay, and what's nice, or what I like to do when I'm practicing all these patterns, if they are different, if they are not copy-pasted two beats at a time, what you could end up doing could be do just two beats and practice those two beats as another rhythm and then piece it together with the next two beats. For example, just do that. Also, let the bar, let the thing continue. Get that. So what's the first two beats? Down, down, up, down, down. So what about beats 3 and 4 now? Let's work on that. 3E and a 4E and a. So that's down, up, down, 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 up. And a 4E and a da 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 num baga jagadum da. Right, now we piece it together. The key is to accent at the 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. Accent accent just means try to play the chord a lot harder. So 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a thin the dun the bow tick a boom. Simple chords, right? It actually sounds good even without chords. So maybe you could start with like just percussion. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. That's why I call it the 3-3-2 feel, because you feel like going in 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. So start with some mutes or ghosts. It still sounds quite cool if you ask me. Bring in a couple of chords. And work on your accents. It's a very important rhythm to have accents. So I hope I've communicated quite a few important things about strumming in this video. We need to work on our ghosting or muting along with some nice percussive elements on the guitar. Then we need to look at improving our study of accents, improving our counting in general, where we need to go 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a... And this was not really a chord lesson as such, but you could start with any chords or any chord progression you know. And as always, search for a sound which you like best. Just keep playing, keep adapting and evolving and see what works for you best, you know. And try to stay as relaxed as possible when you're playing the guitar, and use your foot for the pulse as much as possible, or use your head or your body to move to the music. That is very, very important. Metronome may be a bit overrated. Do that later once you're sure of your own body's timing. When you have your own internal clock running, then you could use things like a metronome and other fancier tools. Right, guys, hope you found the lesson useful. This was 5 slightly intermediate strumming patterns because I use 16th notes with accents and stuff. Do stay tuned for more lessons from Nathaniel. We'll be doing theory, we'll be doing ear training, we'll be doing composition, we'll be doing obviously piano, which the channel seems to do a lot of, and a lot more on different subjects in the field of music. You could also head over to our Patreon page, where this entire set of guitar strumming patterns will be notated and available for you, where you see exactly what you need to do, and the visuals should hopefully help you nail these things going forward. Thanks a ton, and I will see you in the next one, or rather you will see me in the next one.